नमस्कार एंड वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल. दिस इज अभय फ्रॉम सीआईटी एनसीईआरटी न्यू दिल्ली. आई विल मॉडरेट दिस वेबिनार टुडे विथ माय कलीग डॉक्टर निधि सिंह. आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द सीरीज ऑफ वेबिनार्स बीइंग ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय सीआईटी एनसीईआरटी एवरी डे फ्रॉम 3:30 टू 4:30 पीएम. द प्राइमरी ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस वेबिनार्स आर to share our understandings, knowledge and skills on utilization of tools and resources for ET and ICT with our fellow colleagues, teacher educators, teachers and students, so that we start using these tools in an optimal fashion for the larger benefits of our students and teachers, especially when most of us have to work from home due to lockdown. So today's topic of webinar is organizing digital resources using Wakelet. Wakelet, as has been informed by the speaker, is a free platform that allows saving, organizing, and sharing content from across the web. To speak on this topic, we have Ms. Chandni Agrawal, who works as the IT head at Maharaja Agrasen Model School in Delhi. She has more than 23 years of teaching experience. She is a cybersecurity awareness coach and a national ICT awardee by the Government of India. She has also worked as a resource person with NCERT, SCERT, and NIOS. She is an MIA expert and Adobe Creative Ambassador. So I now hand over the platform to Ms. Chandni Agrawal. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. I am highly thankful to NCERT and the team to invite me to talk upon this topic. So today's topic is organizing digital resources using Wakelet. Wakelet is a tool, and right now we have so many digital resources, and we use so many devices, so many cloud platforms to store, to organize our work. Sometimes we are working, we are saving in our mobile phone. Sometimes we are saving on your computer hard disk or to the cloud. Say the different form of storage we are using on cloud. So it's difficult to organize the things, and especially to remember the things, what data is that in which folder and which PDF is where. And so sometimes it creates mess and our work hampers with this such kind of organization of data. So I am moving to the possible solutions we are currently using. So we are storing our work in Google Drive, organizing all the documents in different folders and subfolders. And sometimes we use blog to store our work or store our links at a particular place. And that too, we need something to host, and or we are using Blogspot and certain other tools are available. Or sometimes we mail to ourselves just for our future reference. We save our work at our different email IDs, like me too. Creates email, different email for different things, and saving our work accordingly. And sometimes we save, if we have Hotmail or Outlook ID, we prefer to save it on OneDrive. And OneNote is also one of the tool available under our Hotmail. So that also allows us to organize our work like a digital diary. But Wakelet recently, this tool is recently developed and got popularity over social media, because this provides us a kind of one-stop platform to store and share everything just by storing the links or uploading the PDF. So in the coming just after a few minutes, I'm going to explain the demonstration, how we can use this, how, what steps we can create and what it allows us. So let's move further. So I am going to discuss about Wakelet. This is a free platform that allows you to save, organize, and share content across the web. So it means there is no limitation. I can upload files from my system. I can take file and content from across the web. So now we will understand Wakelet in four steps. So these are our four basic concerns we want to bookmark. So right now, if I ask you one question, if you see, you can write answer in chat window. If you see any good URL, you are exploring something and you just clicking on different links and stepping forward. So what is your action when you see a good URL? How you store that particular URL for future use or for future reference? How you save? So generally we bookmark the web page, and slowly our number of bookmarks got created, and we also forgot what bookmark we stored and we where we have stored. Second point comes to organize the work. So nowadays we have flood of information. Information overflow is there. So we need to organize our work. We see, like being a teacher involved in so many WhatsApp group, Facebook, Twitter, social media. So we got so many resources, so many PDFs, so many notes, video links, which are of our subject. But what we see, we just make them again on WhatsApp. We just make them star message and remove other messages in case of we want to remove the garbage from our phone. So again, we have to download, upload, the such things we need to perform. Other ways of organizing, I told you, you are storing, saving in your drive and saving links in the form of QR code and somewhere you are storing the things. So in this way, we are organizing our data. Till date, we are organizing our data like this. Then third concern is collaborate. So collaboration is not merely means that I have shared file with you and I have shared file with my four or five IDs and we people are collaborators. No, collaborator means we are like contributor to that particular project under which we have assured responsibilities on our shoulder to perform something. So so we can collaborate, and collaboration is like a good teamwork. And last is share. So we want to share it with our community. We want to share it with our students. So we need to share our resources. So this gives us all the four points. Bookmark, we can bookmark our links. So this link can be anything across the web. We can save the content. Next is organizing our bookmark into collections. Suppose I want to create my social science collection for class 6. I can store all the bookmarks there at one place, and then later I can share that particular Wakelet collection with my students as a view link. We can collaborate with other peer educators, or we can give students as a project work to collaborate upon. Then we have share once our collection is finished, and we can keep on adding the collection to our Wakelet. So we can choose it privately, like we can keep it private for our own use, or we can share it with the world. So in this way, we can share it on any platform, say Teams. We can share it on Google Classroom, on share it on Facebook, Twitter, anywhere. So now, and more things are there. You can notify users. You can export entire collection in the form of PDF. Like if I want to send this compiled PDF at one place, I can send, I can download. So I am going to show you each and every part of the demonstration, keeping time as a constraint during this presentation. And even if I have, we have blog or we have website, we can embed our Wakelet into our HTML page or our blog. And if we we are giving our open licenses to copy anyone our resource, in that same way we can also allow people to copy our Wakelet collection. So we can start with onboard to Wakelet. So let's see how we can create a magic with this wonderful tool. And the first step, like every tool, we need to sign up. We need to sign up with any email ID, social media account. You can continue with Facebook. You can continue with your Microsoft ID, continue with your any Google ID, or you can sign up with your email. So in this way, once you are registered with this, you are you can sign in with the further use. So I am telling you the next part, how to create a Wakelet collection. So first time when you open Wakelet, you will see this screen. Here you have to sign up. So once you sign up, it's free. Sign up, you can be a part of Wakelet community. Next is, I have already opened some links for demonstration. Like I have signed in already into my ID. For example, I have created some Wakelets. I'll show you. Like this I have created for my school to give demonstration about online teaching. So teachers' queries are moreover similar whenever we start our work in phases. So I have created this and I have just written some helping points and I have shared video links and PDF here. Now I'll tell you first how we can create a new collection. So once you click on create a new collection button, these all are your buttons and your parameters we can have. So first of all, I am like, for example, I am creating a Wakelet collection. I am creating a Wakelet collection on say, it's a compendium of MOOC courses or the links from where I can have MOOC courses. So sometimes we are sharing our concern about nowadays it, during remote learning phase, we can professionally, we can do some courses for our professional development and have some MOOC courses online. So there are so many links every time we speak about, but we don't have any collection of such kind. So we can start with the first, you will write your online collection. I'm randomly taking any topic coming in my mind.
Excuse me, yes, ma'am. Can you repeat how to start it? Because some yes. people are having.
Okay. Wakelet.com. Once we write that web address and this screen will appear. If I have my account, if I have signed up already, I'll click on login. Here I will enter my email ID and I will login into this. If I am new user, I have to sign up with my any email ID and rest of the part are same, like we register with any other platform. So they will send us a link and we are going there. So in this way, we can sign in into Wakelet. So I am coming back to this page. Once you are here, it has four buttons. Number one is home. This is our profile. So this is our profile window. Here we can edit our profile and we can share it with others. So this will show us the entire collection. It's like our changing our profile and our information. This screen that you are watching is dashboard. So this is ID of Wakelet, of my Wakelet ID @ChandniAgarwal1910. So this is my ID username. So if I want to share anyone my Wakelet ID, this is my Wakelet ID. And these are my summary of collections. Like I have created 10 Wakelets. Every Wakelet collection will come here. It is the new, you can say the new whatever store you are creating is called a collection. Because you are creating a collection of some resources, some links. Then we have bookmarks. Bookmarks means the links, the web addresses you are storing are termed as bookmarks. So in all the 10 collections, say I have stored 375 bookmarks. Group collection means the collection I have created and I have made contributors on that collections. So this is a kind of summary. So we can follow up people and other peoples can follow us on Wakelet also. So it is showing I am following 3 people and 44 people are following me. So next is I am on the creation of our Wakelet. So for this one is our And this can also be downloaded as app on Play Store and Apple Store. So now I am coming back to this creating a new collection. So click on this plus button. It will open a new page. So this page is basically how to create a new collection. So we have beautiful images available here. So number one, plan your collection. See, if I am creating for my class, my subject, so I can give title accordingly. Number two, I can make my wakelet private, public or unlisted. So what is the visibility modes and what is their means? So I have three modes of creating a collection. Public, everyone can see the collection, like we see the collection of others. And so if I make it public, everyone can see. Unlisted means only people with the link can see the collection. Suppose if I want to make it restricted to few people, I don't want that people search it and they can see. So I'll make it unlisted. For private, only I can see the collection and I cannot give any share right to my private collection. And the private collections are only visible to the user. So let's start with creating a small collection. For this, I have started with online MOOC collection, right? So here I can write demonstration. According to this is a collection. Of resources and links and so on, right? So here I can put my whatever text, whatever description I want to give. Next is uploading image from your system. So suppose I want to give here, I want to give some image to my background, and always take care of. This is open image. I am using it. So here I can save it. I can increase or decrease the size of image. So if I want full cover image or I want half cover image, I can use this. Next part is if you want to change, so you can change it anytime. Then we have title. Now next part comes. Now if I want to make it private, public or unlisted, I can make it here. If I am making it unlisted first, once I am contributing the people, I want to make it unlisted. Now comes to share the resources. Now for example, if I want to add some text here, so I have just some text here written already. So here I can copy this text. I can make heading the entire text. I can hide the heading. So I can make text accordingly. I can provide hyperlink to any text by clicking here and posting the link address. Suppose I am writing Swayam. I am copying Swayam address here. Add link. So now this will become my hyperlink and say done. Now if you see, this becomes a link. When we run this, when we use this, it will become a hyperlink part. How to add text. Next, I am telling you how to paste any URL. Suppose I want to paste this my YouTube video here as a URL of some demonstration or some part. So if you see, it has included the video here. Now I want to add description. So here I can add my own description that this video demonstrates so and so part. I can write and I can save it. So if you see, in this way I can include any YouTube video here. Next is I can tweet part I'll demonstrate separately, because this will include some tweets. And this is a separate part I'll explain. Next is bookmark. So these are the bookmarks I have used in my other resources. Now suppose I want to include this remote teaching and learning resources from Microsoft, for example. So I'll say add. Now if you see, this is like my question bank, or this is my separate bookmark, but it has become part of my this particular collection. So till now I have told about pasting a URL, adding a text. This one is directly linked to YouTube. Add whatever you are searching here, it will straight away add to your, if this channel appears. So say if I want to add one particular video here directly from channel, I can add. I am telling this again, go to YouTube. Suppose if I want to add NCERT official channel, I am searching for, and I want to include this particular video. I'll select the video and this video will appear. So I am saving this and I'll show you this collection, how it will be displayed. So this is my collection, created collection. And in this way, I can include that video is not appearing. Actually, it was saved. Again, I'm just including and see what happened. So this is under save. Done. Right? So in this way, I can insert. So till now, is there any question?
There are a few questions. Someone is asking that how much is the capacity? What is the storage capacity?
Okay, I'm coming to that point. There is no storage because actually we are storing very less data, and that too on cloud of Wakelet. And on that part, I'm coming. Right till now, I have only shared the links of cloud storage or any other website link I am storing, or YouTube video link I have stored. So now I am explaining this part. If I have done,
ma'am, somebody is asking what is the function of enable copy.
I'm coming on all the points. Let me complete with the tools.
Please have a little bit of patience.
Yeah,
ma'am is coming to
yeah. Now I want to add more resources, right? So edit collection, click on edit collection, select the, now suppose you are revisiting the Wakelet again, opening your Wakelet next time. So again, click on edit, select the collection, click on edit collection. Now, next is plus. So I have told you about these till here. Now I want to insert a particular image, say image from library. So it has a good library of images. You can search, say if I want to search book, for example. So it will give me one book and I can. Now I want to edit something. I want to write about this image. So I can write caption here. Book so and so. So here I can write about the image. Sometimes we create mind map and we save mind map as image. And we can further, as I will show you one collection of mine for created for class 10 students, and that too shared with students of, I have shared that with peer educators, educator community, and all are using that. So I'll show you views of that particular Wakelet also. So I can upload the image, I can choose from library. So, and also I can write caption about the image, and then we can upload PDF. Once you click on plus, it will move into cross and this toolbar will appear. So right now I have explained about paste URL. This URL can be any link. For example, if I click on this link and I can paste this URL, this will appear here. So URL is not, URL is not taking any separate space on Wakelet. It's just showing you the thumbnail And now it's up to you if you want to write description for your students or for yourself. Here you can write further description. Then I have told about adding a text. You can write the text here, like the first opening post. It's kind of post you are writing. You write on Facebook, you write certain post. In the same way, you can write something about your collection or about your notes or about anything here on the text part. Then I have told about you directly copying any video from YouTube. So one method I told about pasting the URL of video. Another method I told you about selecting any video channel directly, and it will show you the collection of that video channel. You can take video from there. So insert video collection in the Wakelet. Then we have a tweet I'll separately. Then I have told you about bookmarks. So this will open the existing bookmarks. Yeah, bookmark is a link already included in different collections of my Wakelet, right? So when I click on bookmark, it will show me the already included my all bookmarks in whatever is there already in my collection. It will show that. Sometimes what happened, I have used one resource in say collection A and I want to reuse in collection B. So I resource in collection A will become a bookmark. Now I want to use that in my another collection. So I will see this particular what is lambda function is coming two times because I have used in two collections. So if I want to say add any say this one, I'll take any, these are all tweets coming on. So if I want to have this PDF, right, I will select the bookmark and say add. So now if you see this PDF appears, basically I have added this PDF previously in my another collection. Now I want to repeat this in my existing collection. So it will, I can just insert bookmark from another place, like you insert one slide in PowerPoint from other slide, other presentation. In this way, it can be reused in more than one collection.
So ma'am, how many videos, etc. we can upload?
Ma'am, actually the maximum limit, I don't know, but you can have hundreds of in this. So like if you see, my one collection has nearly 375 items.
Right.
So we can have a huge collection, right?
So it's a way of organizing all the things that you have posted, or you can have an online as well as offline. Offline. Also, right?
I'm coming to offline part also. Mm-hmm. So I have told you about image. Like for example, when we can have image in our collection, sometimes we have a cropped portion from any book. Or we have any photograph. Suppose I have my class photograph and I want to have collection of photographs as a Wakelet with demonstration, a kind of photo album. And sometimes we give a work, project work to our students, like draw something and click the photograph. So they can draw a picture story and they can click the photographs and upload the scanned images from their system in the Wakelet. So it can be, it can become a storyteller in this way. If we are just uploading the images and making all things together, and now this upload PDF, this part is offline part. So when I click here for uploading any PDF, see, I'll show you uploading one PDF. I'll show you one PDF. So, for example, I have this PDF flowchart. So, this is on my system. And now I want to upload it. Like, suppose I want to make my create my private collection of my certificates, of my all educational certificates and professional certificates. So I have scanned copies. Say if I have scanned copies of all the certificates, I can upload them one by one, and that becomes my collection of my all certifications, my qualification, profession. So we can, it's up to us how innovatively we can use, make use of the collection.
So how secure this platform is?
Yes, ma'am. If you make it private, then no one can see your wakelet. It's as secure as your email ID.
Okay.
Yes. So like if I want that, I want to change image of this PDF, right? So now I want to choose from library. Say if I want, I'll check if there is flowchart available or not. So there is a flowchart symbol. So I can take images from this. So relevant images say not coming, but if I take this one and say done, so I can change my flowchart image, PDF thumbnail, because PDF was showing simple thumbnail. And here I can share this PDF contains notes about class 11 flowchart chapter. So in this way we can mention for our reference, right? So
there is a question, can we make multiple IDs on this platform for different work?
But no, we don't need multi. I'm coming to that point. Last option, I'm telling you, OneDrive. Suppose I have already logged in into one of my ID, this one, O365 or Hotmail. So you directly go to OneDrive. Now, once you are already logged in and you open this, so it will show me my OneDrive, right? So I can include any file openly. So for example, if I have 12th Python work, say I have this OneNote. One second.
Actually, whenever we are using for any educational purposes, we have to see the images who are open. For any platform, any use, if we are for educational purpose or any other purpose, so we need to keep that in mind. So
So they can use that search option from where they can download the images which are not copyrighted and labeled for reuse.
So ma'am, can anybody follow see those, if you have shared your wakelet page or to someone else, then he or she can access, see it, right? It's private. If it's private, then nobody can see it. It's like
yes,
email,
ma'am.
ID.
Yes, ma'am. So I have told you about all the sources, and this is enable copy. Now when I on this enable copy, and if you see my wakelet, like if I share you this link, so you can copy this. You can copy my wakelet as a duplicate copy. So it allows you to copy it. If I make this option off, it's like we have open source libraries and people can copy the code and work if we allow them. So if I on this option, it will allow to copy the wakelet collection. If I make it off, then we can only view, we cannot copy it. In the same way, this we can add background image to our wakelet.
If I want to access your wakelet page, do I need to have an account in that wakelet itself, or you can share it with others?
Okay, so if it is a public wakelet, public one, and you want to view, so at that time you need not to have wakelet ID. But if it is unlisted and you have a link, then you have to sign in, and then you can see. And for
So how can teachers use it for in the classroom or
yes,
for their teaching purpose?
I'm coming to that point. Just last thing I'm telling you. So our next part is contributors. So I suppose I want to add contributor, right? So I can share this code 47D23DA and this copy link to my contributor directly if I don't have their email ID. But if I have their email ID, I can write here email ID. Suppose I am writing here, say, email ID and say add. So if you see at the bottom, one second. If you see when I have added the contributor, it is coming, one second, I have to add again. I am writing here. I am writing my mail ID here. For example, I am writing my ID. I am adding it, right? Now this is added as contributor. If I see manage contributor, I am admin of it. And when I say send, one second. So I have to press send button. Shulina, that point is coming on the screen. So I'm not able to click that send button on my screen. This toolbar is coming. So when we add contributor, we can give name or email ID of the person and click send button. So that person will receive email from the administrator to contribute on that particular wakelet. And you need to share that code also. So in this way, we can add contributors to our wakelet. We cannot add contributors to private wakelet, but we can add contributors to public and unlisted wakelet. And how teachers can share with their students, that I'll show you. We can copy this link to our students and send to them. They can, we can send them this QR code. We can share collection using this link. Click on share button. Even we can share directly to the Google Classroom. We can share on the Teams. We can share it Facebook, Twitter, and other platforms. And even we can copy this link. Link copied. And we can directly mail this link, or we can send them via any media, SMS or WhatsApp to the students to see this wakelet collection. So in this way we can share. Last part comes the embed part. In the embed part, we will have our embed code generated here. So this code can be embedded in our website or in our blog. And I can directly export this into PDF. Once I'll export, it will automatically save in the form of a PDF file. Now I'll show you just one collection. Now, if you download it, I'll show you how it looks like. So if you see, I have entire PDF with all the links. So this, right? So one second, let me come back to this last point. And we can change our visibility anytime. And last thing is the view of this collection. One second. I am using this one, and it will show mood board. Mood board means it will look like this. So these are different views of wakelet collection. So you were asking how a teacher can share that. I have,
ma'am, can you just repeat how to embed that process?
Okay, I'll show in my blog page. One second. Let me show you this. This I have created for my class 10 students. This wakelet, right? If you see, the views are 1,452. So we were facing a problem. I was just sharing all these resources like all the PDF uploaded on CBSC site, their books. We have sample papers. I have created so many assignments. So all these I have created as a Wakelet collection.
So right. So you have put all the resources that you have created at and you have
yes.
put it at a one place. Maybe a book form, online virtual book form.
Yes,
right,
yes, yes. And the links of video resources, links of and one wonderful feature is it has immersive reader.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have text action and see this kind. So this has the feature of immersive reader and plus if you see if you have some text you can this one. So it has picture dictionary also and you can select a language. Say you can select Hindi and convert it into different languages. So it has wonderful feature of immersive reader too.
Okay.
So, yeah. And we can see this and we can translate into entire, when we say entire document, it will see it has converted into Hindi.
Mm-hmm.
And start this. So if you see it has all good features and if I have text it can read. So it will read the text.
So that means you have generated different e-resources
yes.
of your particular subject, whatever class you are teaching related to that.
Yes.
And
yes.
then you have posted, you have assembled all the resources in one way and you have shared it with your students. So
yes.
all the resources, e-resources that you wanted to share with them have been kept at one place. And in
yes.
one Wakelet, and then they can access. They need not search here and there, and need not get lost in how many things are there. So they have to access, right, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. And so,
I think those who were asking how to use it during class or how to use it in teaching learning, so they have, I think, got the answer for it.
Yes, I'll tell one this point. Like we have community showcase option, you see at the top. So this has a great collection of created Wakelets. The Wakelets we make public, it is visible here. And
so, ma'am, do the students also need to create a Wakelet ID of
no,
their own?
No. It is open. We are giving them view right. They can. We are sharing them link. They can simply open it. I'll show you this in incognito mode. I don't require any kind of ID. When I make it public, I don't need any ID to share. Say copy and see in incognito mode. I am pasting it. Yes, ma'am. Your question? What was
the ma'am, offline, how to work in the offline mode?
Ma'am, it will not work in offline mode. It is the offline mode can be export PDF and download it. And then we can work.
Share it. Huh?
So see, this is, I have not signed up. Login sign up screen is coming. And here the person who created the Wakelet will be there. And I can save this as a bookmark. So no one require any kind of sign up if they want to use public Wakelet. So I was explaining that one more wonderful last option I am explaining. Then we will take the questions.
Mm-hmm.
One second, I was. Yeah. Okay. So suppose I want to search some resources of Python, right? So see, this is only showing my collection. But if I search here, this one. If I search here and write here Python, so you see how many I'll get many collections from other creators. So I can use this. These all are open collections. So suppose this contains 20 items of programming Python. So sometimes I can also get some good things. So now he has given option to copy the collection. So I can copy this. If I need, I can copy. So this is in another language, and they have created resources of Python. So we can use it if we need. So they have given us the permission. So in this way, we can search for whatever we want to have. We can have collection of resources here already done as a public. So thank you so much. Is now I am open for questions.
No. So ma'am, some of the questions that we have is like about do we need to download it?
No, it's online.
Online, as you said, right?
And one thing, I'll show you one more thing. It comes recently, 2-3 days back, it comes as extension also to Chrome and Edge, right? So see, if I click on this Chrome extension, the tabs which are already open, they will come that say, if I am here, one second. If I am here in the Swayam, its Swayam portal is opened. I want to add this to my collection.
Mm-hmm.
So if I click on, I have to add Wakelet to my extension. So if you see, I want to add this to my online MOOC collection. So I need not to go to my collection and add separately. If I have Chrome extension, it can be directly added. So it will come here. It will not, just it's see, unknown resource it is coming because I have not given any name to this particular collection, this post. So it will automatically add it. And once I just added this text, it will come accordingly. So it's not directly that you need to edit collection and add separately. If you have extension, you have opened the tab and just add to your required collection.
Ma'am, can you just quickly show the embedding part, how to embed?
Okay. Suppose I want to have new post, right? And I want to embed, say, this wakelet. So I'll select on embed. I'll take the copy embed code. And paste here and see the preview. So it will automatically come here. Is this clear?
I think it must have. And those who are asking again for the offline mode, under the embed button, there was export to PDF. Then you can click on that option and then you can export it in PDF. A PDF file will appear and then you can save that.
I'll show you. Go to 3 buttons and click on PDF export, right? So it will automatically down like this. Just I have downloaded this one. So you can use this as a collection of your text. Once you are in the online mode, you just create your everything. You copy text from one place to another and make hyperlinks, create a collection and download it for your offline mode use.
Those collections, those things that you want to share can only be shared. It entirely depends upon ourselves that you, whatever you want to share with your students or first your or with your colleagues. So everything cannot be shared unless you add that video or PDF or image or anything in your wakelet, right? So ma'am, few other questions. How is it similar to OneDrive and how it is different from Google Drive and Padlet?
Okay, ma'am, if we talk about
quickly, yes,
OneDrive is just storing your documents on cloud and we need to explore and we need to juggling between the files and folders to find out a particular thing, and also it doesn't store any kind of URLs for that. You need to make a document where you can copy and paste the links, and then you have to remember the name of that particular page where you have stored all the links on embedded parts. And Padlet is a kind of just a wall where we post our things, and it's a kind of it doesn't provide that much power that it provides. And we can create number of collections, and we also have already shared resources by other contributors that we can freely use.
So collaboration is also possible if you share your students, share your
Yes, I have told you about this feature, contributors.
Right.
Yes, in this way we can add contributors through their email IDs. For that, they need to enter this code that I have, this one, shareable. So they need a code also when you contribute to them.
So can they work in a collaborative mode in real time?
Yes, ma'am.
They like can. Google Drive?
Yes, they can work.
Right. And there are several languages you can explore. Be it Tamil or some other language you can explore on your own.
Immersive reader in the immersive reader.
Right.
Here, when they click here, see this shows us grammar options also if they want. So how to pronunciate the things, it is there. This is for text preferences for visually impaired ones, that for the special needs students. And this picture dictionary is also available. And you were talking about conversion into another language.
Different languages. Right?
Yes, different languages. Once again. Say we go to Kannada and I want to transfer in. So it has, see, it is changed into Kannada. I don't know this, so but here the speech option is disabled. So this is enabled for few of the options like Hindi and I think other foreign languages. And this is my original one, and this is the translated part.
So ma'am, is there any option like live speech embedded in the Wakelet? Can you speak?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
That text to speech option is not available.
Ma'am, storage capacity of Wakelet, anything on that? How much? Since it's in cloud form, it's online form.
Yes. So we are saving, rarely we are saving any data.
Mm-hmm, right.
Yes. Even we can create collection of tweets. So we can just write that tag. For example, like some people are very fond of using social media. So simply we can, or we need to store our tweets, right? So say for example, if I want to search, say give me some tag we have remote teaching. Say I am writing my right? So wherever this ID is mentioned, all the tweets will come, and slowly it will increase when I move down. So in this way we can create our collection with tweets, so we can store our tweets in one place. We need not to search again.
I think the time is up now.
Thank you madam.
Thank you, sir.
It was very informative presentation, or comprehensive. I think Dr. Nidhi has already taken up most of the questions. There are few which our participants have asked quite at the end, something like, do we need any account to create, do we need to create an account to start Wakelet?
Sir, any email ID can work to sign up with the Wakelet. We had a Facebook ID with any email ID. We have Twitter ID with sign up with our any email ID. It can be Gmail, it can be Hotmail, or it can be our organizational ID.
Resources which uses proprietary software, can that be shared using Wakelet, say for example Word or?
Yes, sir. Sir, actually if you see the demonstration, it store online links. If I am using, say for example, let me show this. For example, this is my office online, right? So I have one Word document here, and I am creating, say, any Word online. I am writing something here. I have shared. Say, I have a share link of, say, view. Right? And and I can copy link here. I can paste in the Wiglet collection.
Ma'am, probably we can also use this Wiglet for school newsletter or yes, college ma'am. Newsletter. Also,
yes,
right?
ma'am. We can create our digital magazine where right. include right now what we are doing. We are doing e-newsletters in the form of printed media. So we can straight away shift to and we can share this link to our parents,
right.
giving them a new link, and even we can say we can create a small digital magazine
right.
and add it in the students'
diary. So the links are also available there, and we if those who want to go into detail, they can click on the link and go further and then access the resources for the
yes, sir. Yes, yes.
So thank
sir,
you, madam.
This is created. Thank you, sir.
And I also like to thank our colleagues, Dr. Nidhi, Dr. Sharda, and Devasis for helping in the smooth conduct of this session. There, of course, there are some hiccups here and there, but nonetheless, we all enjoyed your presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much,
thank
sir,
you.
For the opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am.
And it's just like it's a big opportunity to serve the nation. So it's a wonderful time for me and wonderful learning with all. Sharing my resources. Thank you so much. Is there any question left? I can answer. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.